So let me give a simple roadmap to know where you are and where you should go next. Every website has two parts, a frontend and a backend. The frontend is the part where you sit in a browser and interact with all the visual aspects. Backend is the part that powers the frontend. It's behind the scene and it's mainly about storing data and databases and providing it to the frontend. So web development jobs fall into three categories: the frontend development, backend development, and full stack development, which involves both frontend and backend development. Frontend developers use HTML, CSS, and JavaScript to build frontend. Backend developers have different set of tools available to them, which we will talk about in the other video. So let's talk about HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. HTML is short for Hypertext Markup Language. We use HTML to define building blocks of our web pages. CSS is short for cascading style sheet, and it is used for styling web pages and making them beautiful. JavaScript is used for adding functionality to the web pages. Here is a real example. Let's say you want to build a real world application like Instagram. For each post, we're going to have a layout like this. So first, we use HTML to define all the visual blocks of this layout. What are these building blocks is here? An image, some text or username, another block of text which contains the message, and some icon for commenting, sharing, and liking. We use HTML to add these building blocks to our web pages. Then we use CSS to give it visual effects. For example, we use CSS to make the font bold. We can make our image round. We can add some padding around here. We can change the color of these icons and define their look when we hover over them. So CSS is all about the aesthetics of visual effects. With CSS, we can also create beautiful animation. Now, most web pages these days are interactive. They respond to our actions, likes, clicks, and scrollings. This is where JavaScript comes in. With JavaScript, we can add functionality and behavior to our web pages. For example, we can like a post. So JavaScript is a programming language, while the HTML and CSS are not. Meaning, we cannot use them to tell computers to what to do. We use them to define the building blocks of our web pages and style them. Every web page you have seen in the internet is built with these three languages. So the better you will learn understanding these languages and their features, the better you will be at front-end development. So your front-end development journey starts with HTML and CSS. I would say if you spend 3 to 5 hours a day studying and coding, you should be able to have a reasonable understanding these two languages in about a month and a half. Once you learn these languages, you need to learn JavaScript. I would say learning JavaScript would probably take another 6 weeks of your time. Of course, you're not gonna be a JavaScript expert in just 6 weeks, but you will have a reasonable understanding and you will learn more as you work in different projects. So the first 3 months is all about fundamentals. Now, building website often includes a bunch of repetitive tasks. This is where front-end frameworks and libraries come in. A frameworks or libraries comes with a lot of code that you can reuse in our websites. So they help us to get the job done faster. That's why a lot of companies these days use one of these popular frameworks like React, Angular, and Vue. Now technically, React is not a framework, it's a library. But actually, all these tools serve the same purpose. They help us build applications faster. Now we don't need to learn all of this to get started. Different companies use different tools for their different projects. As you move from one project to another, you may want to learn about the other tools. If you're starting out, just focus on React, because it's the most popular tool in this space. Once you learn React, you can always learn the other tools if needed. For React, you would probably need 1 to 2 months. Alright, for the next steps, version control systems. We use a version control system to keep track of our project's history and work collaboratively with others. There is many version control systems out there like Git, Subversion, Mercurial, and so on. But Git is the most popular tool in this space and it's used more than 70% of software development companies. That's why you see its every job's description. I would say you would probably need another 2 weeks to learning Git. So these are essential skills for every front-end developer must have. You'll see this list in almost every job description, which is front-end. Now, different jobs require other skills. but these skills is vary from one company to another. So you can learn these additional things in the future for on the job. For now, just focus on these four skills or four steps. Remember, less is more. Don't try to learn too many things quickly. You won't learn anything. You will just waste your time. Alright, that's your roadmap. And of course, don't forget to subscribe and share with your friends.